All Rosie needs is someone to care about her. Showing her there's something more to look forward to the morning than being depressed all day.
I know what you're saying, but...
What do you say? You give it a belt? For her sake.
Don't you dare tell me Meg Morris didn't have something to do with you talking me into this.
Excuse me, I was wondering if I could see Sister Hall.
Why didn't you ask me earlier? I'm right in the middle of meal round.
I'm sorry, but I still feel nauseous, and she said...
Well, you'll just have to hang on till I've finished. There isn't an officer available to take you.
Jeez, you little beauty! You didn't waste much time, did you? Hey, she know who you were?
Yeah, she told the pigs. They've been around here already, the bastards.
Get rough, did they?
No more than usual. So they did the place over trying to find something else to pin on us.
Some hope.
Had to get up bloody early in the morning and catch out the old Slash.
Good on you. Hey, wreck off, will you, Nat? Not you, Slasher. Go on, I've got some private things to say to lover boy here.
Okay.
Oh, no, don't worry about it. Anything you say to her gets lost in the sawdust. You got to see her to believe her.
I'll take your word for it. Hey, we're going to have a turn later for getting back at old freak features.
Yeah? Jeez, I wish I was there. It'll give me a high just seeing her face in the morning, though, rotten bitch.
Don't worry, Rita. She's bloody sorry now she ever laid eyes on
the... What? Gotta go, Slash.
Howdy, hi.
What on earth's the matter with... And what do you think you're up to, Connors?
Oh, a bit of exercising. You know, Barbie has been showing me a few.
Oh, I'm sure you were. But never mind about that now. You've got visitors.
Who, me?
No, your Aunt Fanny. Come on.
I thought I wasn't allowed visitors.
That doesn't extend to the police force.
The cops? What do they want?
I'm sure you've got a fair idea.
Haven't a clue.
Hey, hold it.
What?
All right, what happened?
Oh, bit of an accident when we were doing our aerobics.
Oh, pull the other one, Connor.
No, why? Stay, Bab, you know.
Hey, cut that out. You don't fool me, Connors, not one little bit. And you can be sure Mrs. Morris will hear about this first thing in the morning.
Yeah,
now, get moving.
Yeah.
And any more of your lip and you'll have more than the police to contend
with. I don't know. Everyone around this dump's getting power crazy.
So did I.
Thank you, Doctor.
Joan, I think you better go and get some rest. I mean, you heard what the doctor said.
They couldn't have hurt me much more, could they?
Have you any idea who it was?
Connor's mates.
Are you sure?
They had stockings over their faces, but it was them. I know it was them.
How could you have known? I mean, what do the police think?
She said I'd pay. She said I'd...
It's all right, Joan. I think you better go to bed.
Yeah, I'm tired. I'm sorry.
Joan, would you like me to stay a while?
Yes. I'd appreciate that. Thank you.
Hey, Rita. Wait, Sam.
Yeah, what's the problem?
Well, that's what I was wondering. I heard the cops were after you.
Yeah, wouldn't you know? A couple of leather jackets took a go at the freak and they're trying to pin it on us bikers.
Well, without seeming nosy, I mean, why they want to pin it on you?
Well, the freak told them to.
Oh, I see. They thought you were getting back at her because what she did to your jacket.
Right on, Jess. You eating the right kind of dog food, huh?
Silly buggers. It's them that needs to change their brand. I mean, how do they think you get the message out?
Exactly what I told them. No visiting rights. Even old Slats had to back me up. It nearly choked them.
Oh, they'd have choked if they'd known about your little CV sessions, eh?
What?
Oh, it's okay. I won't blab.
How do you know? Who else knows? Come on.
Nobody. I mean, I helped to hide it.
Yeah, well, let's just keep it that way, okay?
Sure, no worries. I mean, from what I've heard about the freak, she deserves every bloody thing she gets.
Boy, does she bloody get it tonight.
And this is from a friend of mine.
I couldn't sleep. I thought you'd have gone by now anyway.
Oh, no, I said I'd stay.
Well, I won't keep you any longer.
Feeling better?
Look, I'm sorry. I really do appreciate you coming over. And thank you for tidying up.
Oh, it's the least I could do. I'm sorry. I think those things in the carton are beyond repair.
Yes.
Senseless act.
Don't think Connors would agree with you.
Joan, I know you're terribly upset, especially about the ruined portrait. But just leave Connors to me.
Yeah, what'll she get? Lose a few privileges, a day in the pound?
We don't have proof it was her, Joan. I mean, she couldn't make contact for a start.
Anybody could have got a message out for us.
That's possible.
Look, it was her mob. And I hope they throw the book at them.
It's not going to happen, Joan. Not at the moment, anyway.
What do you mean?
The police called back. All the conquerors have alibis.
So?
I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, you save your sympathy for Connors because she's going to need it.
You listen to me, Joan. I may be only acting governor, but it still gives me the power to suspend you from duty if you so much as touch a hair of her head. Now, I said I'd take care of it, and I will.
Yeah.
Maybe Merv's holding Joyce's hand again.
Well, I'm in no hurry to eat lentils. It's porridge again.
Well, what are you doing here, then? Come to decorate the place, have you?
Well, it'll make up for your ugly mugglers.
Hey, where's the grub?
Oh, in my left eyeball.
Yeah, the cops paid you another visit last night. Lady been up to her old tricks, eh?
No.
She didn't know about this one.
How do you know? I could have sworn they didn't know about my pills, either.
She might have. But it didn't do her much good.
Yeah, probably just luck, that's all.
Lou, we've got to do something soon.
Don't worry.
Only this time, Wyndham won't be screwing it up.
Still spouting off, eh, Lou? Good to know there's something you can rely on around here.
Yeah, you're right for once, Wyndham.
Honey, I'm still going to fix your girlfriend as soon as I can arrange it.
Won't do you much good. You want the lager, you better look in your own backyard.
Nice try. I've told Lou about our little talk.
Yeah, and I don't buy it. But keep it up. I like a good laugh.
Seems to me the laugh's on you.
particularly if you haven't got the brains to work it out for yourself.
Keep it up, lard belly, and there'll be a double funeral. Right, come on.
Oh, sorry.
Hey, look, don't worry about Lou. She's all here.
Not entirely, love. I mean, Lexi's in hospital, you know.
She's only trying
to... Connors? Governor's office.
Oh, get out. I haven't had any breakfast yet.
Oh, you'll survive. Come on.
Hey, you can't do that. We've got a right to three meals a day.
Shut up, Kelly. Yes, no one's asking you.
Well, then I'm making a formal protest. What do you say, girls?
Yeah.
All right, I'll let the governor know.
Great. And I'll tell him they forgot to salt them. Bitches, they reckon they can get away with anything. Wonder what they want Rita for. Who cares? We've got more important things to worry about. All I'm saying is she could have waited. It stinks.
That'll do. You're in enough trouble already without bringing any more charges on yourself.
Oh, God, what have I done now?
Well, there's a matter of two broken windows, and you're also under strong suspicion for the attack on Miss Ferguson last night.
Oh, yeah, right. I got my own gold pass to take off whenever I like.
I know you're denied contact with the outside, but that doesn't mean to say you didn't manage to organise it. Under the circumstances, I've decided to have you transferred from Wentworth as soon as possible.
Wait.
Take her back, Mrs. Slattery.
Now, hang on a minute.
Come on, Connors.
Hands off, Screw! Where am I going? You can at least tell me that.
That'll be up to the department.
Oh, great. Just great. Stick up for your own, don't you? Ferguson rips me jacket and I get the
fight.
You bet. And the sooner the better.
Connors!
Your morning tea, Governor.
Oh, just what I need. Thanks, Mervyn. How's Joyce today?
Getting cheekier by the minute. It's a great relief.
Yes, I'm sure it is. Oh, I miss her. Be good to have her back again. And thank you for this.
My pleasure. I can see you're very busy, but I was wondering if you could spare me a few minutes. I have something I'd like to talk to you about.
Oh, of course. Actually, I think I look busier than I really am. Sit down.
It's about the handyman's position, actually. I think I know someone who would be quite suitable for the job. He comes highly recommended. In fact, you've already met him.
Oh, who is it?
Steve Ryan, the young doctor who was so kind to Joyce.
Just a minute, Mervyn. A doctor wants to be a handyman.
Well, I suppose it does seem a bit unusual, but he has very good reasons. And he worked his way through medical school as a handyman at one of those large blocks of flats. He has excellent references.
All right, I'll see him. Get him to ring me, will you?
Well, as a matter of fact, I suggested he'd ring you this morning.
Oh, after you had a chance to talk to me?
Yes.
All right, I promise you I'll see him.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
Now, is there anything else I can do, Mervyn?
No, nothing at all. Sorry to have taken up so much of your time.
Hey, what did Mrs. Morris want you for?
Still trying to pin the freak's little shake-up on me. What else?
It's true, they don't give up, do they?
Bastards are shipping me out as well.
What they are for?
Who bloody knows? They need a reason.
Jeez,
that's tough, Ree. I wouldn't care if it was somewhere close, but you bet your life it'll be way up country.
So bad about that. I thought country prisons were easier on you.
Yeah, sure. Especially when your mates are all in town.
Oh, go on. Don't tell me they won't pay you a visit. After all, it's not as though they've got jobs or anything to keep them here, is it?
You saying they're a pack of bludgers, Wilder?
No, of course not.
Yeah, well, you've got to remember that it's very hard to get jobs these days.
Yeah, and from what I hear, the conquerors have got no problems. They've got easier ways of making money than work.
Listen, be corners!
Oh, g'day, Mr. Slattery. Just getting all the girls to line up for you properly. Come on, girls, line up.
Get against the wall. And yes, not another word. Oh,
she's still in hospital.
Right.
Some cooking for
Lou, she didn't do it.
And I say she did.
Shut up, Kelly.
I was just worried about me mate Patterson, that's all.
No need. She's out of the infirmary this morning. Now, can we get on with it, please? Thank you. Laundry. Jenkins, Kelly, Wilder, Cox, Egbert, Kennedy and Murray. Kitchen. Linmai, Corbett, Balzano, Wyndham. Wyndham, what are you doing here?
What?
You were supposed to stay on kitchen duty.
Oh, no, just for breakfast and tea, Mrs.
Oh, that's right. You're
look
on
here.
Cleaning.
Lexi can't work. She's sick.
I didn't say she was working, did I? Now move out. You've got 5 minutes to get to your work areas.
So we've got a busy morning, girls.
Yeah, nothing like skinning a dingo to break the monotony.
Julie, we gotta do something quick.
Yeah.
Look, you hop along to the dorm and I'll go and find Lexi.
Yeah.
Oh, hell, I told her to stay here.
It's okay, I thought you were a screw.
Oh, it's good to see you.
Listen, I know you didn't do it.
Oh, thanks, mate. But convincing Kelly's not going to be so easy.
It's awful. How can they just kill somebody without any proof?
Well, they think they got it, remember?
Still reckon it was that Wilder woman?
Oh, stake my life on it. But that's beside the point. What we've got to do now is to get them off your back.
Yeah, I'll be in that.
Come on, we better get going. If the screw comes, we'll all be in trouble.
Hey, listen, maybe we could hide her somewhere till we can prove she's not the
one. No! Yeah. It's too difficult. You've got to... Hey, I've thought of something. Yeah?
What? Hang on.
Well, look, what I think of is crazy, but still, give us a chance to think of something better later.
I don't believe this. What are you all doing out here?
Oh, yeah, well, I had to go and get a...
Forget it. I'm not interested in stories.
Look, Mrs.
If you're not back in your work areas in 1 minute, you'll all be on a charge.
Where are we going to go now?
The toot. No. We're going to front Kelly with it right now.
You're kidding.
Oh, no. Never more serious. I'll let you know what we're doing as we go.
Better be bloody good.
And then you and Lurch grab her and bring her up here.
It'd be less messy to put her in the dryer. Someone seemed to think that'd work with Ferguson.
Yeah, but it didn't. And we want to be sure.
Well, what's the difference? She'll still cook.
But this way we get to have some fun. So you hold her head in here and whammo, steam rains.
Grab her, Lurch.
Going somewhere? You're not going to blow out of the plan, are you? Good. There's one squeak out of you, bird brain. It'll be a permanent body bar. You got that?
Why don't you pick on someone your own size, Kelly?
Oh, Patterson. We've been waiting for you. Ronnie Turner, keep near.
Leave her alone, Lou.
We voted and the bitch goes.
Not while I'm here, she doesn't.
How can you change easy?
You're off your face, Kelly. I'm not the lag.
Like hell,
you're
pregnant. She's pregnant.
Hey? Yeah. You want to kill my kid too?
Mechanical too. Well, we could certainly use that.
Well, then I'm hired.
Oh, well, no, not quite. But hopefully, with a little pushing, we can cut the inevitable red tape to a minimum.
Good. The sooner the better.
One more thing. I can understand why you want a job away from your own profession at the moment, but I would need some sort of guarantee that I won't be looking for a replacement after a couple of months.
Mrs. Morris, I promise you I won't run away. A year, okay?
Well, this is a woman's prison. You'll need to be constantly on your toes, especially with your looks.
I know what you mean. I've been there. It's a bit of an occupational hazard around the hospital, but I've learnt my lessons.
Well, I still think you don't know what you're in for, but I'm certainly willing to give you a try.
Oh, thanks. Well, you won't regret it.
No, hang on. There's still the department security check yet, but I'm sure there'd be no problem there.
Oh, that's great. I know this might be asking a bit much, but I'd really love to have a look around the place.
Right. I'll take you myself and make sure you see the bad points as well as the good.
Are you still trying to scare me off?
Well, let's just say I'd hate to have you start and then find out in 2 days that it's not quite your style.
Ah, that won't happen. Believe me.
Oh, it's bull, Patterson.
Yeah, how'd you manage it?
How do you reckon? Bit hard to make it up, isn't it? She's 2 months gone.
Yeah, well, I say she's lying.
Oh, no. Maybe a phantom pregnancy.
After all, she is the phantom lager. Yeah, well, I don't care what she's pulling. It doesn't change her.
Let me alone, you bitch! You hurt that baby, Lou, and you'll have the women down on you like a ton of brick.
You remember what happened with Nora's baby?
Hell, Lou, it's a kid. Okay, then prove it.
We wait 9 months.
All right, Patterson, prove it. Who and when?
Get out. I thought you were against laggers, Kelly.
This is different. Now start talking, Patterson.
No bloody way.
She'll get him into trouble, Lou.
Well, it hasn't worried her up to now.
Get stuffed. Look, this is wasting time. Let's just ask us crew. If she's pregnant, they'll all know about it by
yeah,
now.
Yeah, Lou, I'll go and do it.
They don't know yet.
Yeah, I thought so. Come on, grab her.
No! Sister knows. Lexi had to pay her not to say anything.
Oh, pull the other one.
No, it's true. Yeah. If the screws found out, will he be in heaps of trouble?
Yeah, not to mention making us suffer through tougher security.
That sounds damn fishy to me.
She can enjoy breathing a bit longer while we check it out, Patterson.
Gee, thanks.
Come. Let's get going before Slattery comes.
You take good care of her. I'd hate anything to happen to her.
It won't. I'll make sure of that.
Well, I wonder who she had it off
with. It's never going to work.
Of course it will. Just don't be so negative.
But I couldn't even convince Sister Hall I was sick. How the hell am I going to talk her into saying I'm pregnant?
Well, you just got to, understand? It's your only hope.
Well, now you've seen the place, you're still as keen to have the job?
I've got one worry.
Huh? What's that?
That I'll get lost in that maze of corridors.
Well, if that's all, I think I'd phone the department straight away.
Oh, thanks. I hate being kept in suspense.
I'll let you know the minute I find out.
That's great. Well, thanks again, Mrs. Morris.
Come in.
Sorry to interrupt.
Mervyn Watt, perfect timing. I need some help.
Oh, of course.
I'm going to change this office around. Give it a new look so that when Anne comes back, it'll all be fresh and different.
What would you like me to do?
Well, I think the first thing I'd like is the desk to be moved right down near the window so that we can get more light.
Right.
Oh,
Mervyn! Oh, sorry.
Oh, my gosh, look at your requisition.
I'm sorry to interrupt, Mrs. Morris. I tried to phone.
Are you the acting governor?
Yes, I am. Who are you?
Moran. Obviously, the department didn't tell you I'd be here today.
No, no, they didn't. Well, what can I do for you?
I'm the new governor.
Oh, come on. I mean, all you've got to do is say yes if anyone asks if I'm expecting. It's nothing.
It's ridiculous. Now, off you go.
Look, it's just a bit of a lark. I mean, it's not going to hurt no one, is it?
Look, I'm glad you found some harmless fun for a change, but I have neither the time nor the inclination to be part of it. Am I getting through?
Yeah.
Mind you, if I were asked, they wouldn't get a yay or a nay anyway. We don't hand out any information from patient files.
Oh, really?
Go.
Oh, thanks. You're okay, you know that?
Just as well you're in Wentworth, Patterson. You're really tempting fate with a story like
spare
that.
Spare me. I'd rather break a leg than have a kid.
Somebody at department is obviously not doing their job. It never entered my head you wouldn't be notified.
Well, I sometimes think they rather enjoy springing surprises on us.
Yes. One way of keeping the staff on their toes, I suppose.
If that's a subtle reprimand for the levity that was going on here a few minutes ago, I can assure you it's not usual procedure.
Don't misunderstand. I've been around the service long enough to realise that a little bit of levity can be a good thing occasionally, just so long as it doesn't interfere with the reason we're here.
I agree. Well, I must clear away my things.
Thank you. Anything major on at the moment?
Well, top of the list is the transfer of one of our inmates, Rita Connors.
I see.
You local or interstate?
Local. Trained at Barnhurst, straight out of the army. Moved around a bit, but spent the last 4 years at Brendan as deputy governor.
This is your first time as governor?
Yes. And I'd like to be able to rely on your full cooperation as my deputy.
That goes without saying.
Thank you. I realize it can't be too easy for you. The department spoke so highly of you, I wondered why they hadn't given you the job.
I didn't apply.
I see. This Connors, troublemaker?
Well, we have reason to believe she organized an outside attack on one of our officers last night.
Last night? You put in the recommendation this morning. A bit quick, isn't it? No definite proof.
Miss Ferguson is convinced she was behind it, and I believe her. Connors has a violent record.
Interesting. Let's find out the facts first, Mrs. Morris. Cancel the transfer order and let's have her in right now.
Hey, Lou, I was thinking. Look, I reckon Lexi's all wind about bribing Sister Hall. What could she give her?
3 cheers for Lurch.
Yeah, what do you say to that, Egbert? Falling to boy George posters, eh?
Lexi gave her the money from the clothes she sold.
Oh, how could she do that? She can't get her hands on
it. It's easy. You authorise somebody else to go and get it for
you. Oh, cut the crap, Egbert. Hall's too straight.
And so's Lexi. She's not the lagger.
Change the record, will you?
I think it's about time you checked it out, Lou.
You're telling me how to do my job?
No, it's just that the longer Patterson's allowed to run free, the more chance she has to drop a few more notes.
Yeah. Bitch. Take over here, will you?
Oh?
And if you're lying, Bert, you'd better start saying your prayers.
So what's this new geezer like?
You'll find out soon enough.
I'm wearing a bloody track to that office.
Well, you've only got yourself to blame.
Like hell.
Hey, get out of my stuff! Connors, get out of here!
What about her? She's got no bloody right in here.
I'm sorry.
She's sharing your cell.
Since when?
Since I authorised it.
Well, so what? She's still got no right to stuff around in my things.
No, please, I'm sorry. I really am. There was nothing to do here. I didn't think you'd mind.
Well, now you know.
Wait out in the corridor, Connors.
Glad to. Let's make sure the Lamington lady here knows the score.
The women have very little to call their own. It tends to make them very possessive.
Yes, I can see that. Don't worry. I certainly won't do it again.
Look, if you get bored, you can always apply to work.
Yes, well, I think about it, but right now I'd rather be on my own for a while.
Well, if you change your mind, just tell an officer.
Yes, I will. Thank you.
Thank you.
Kelly, must you? What do you want?
Well, I just came to get the dirty linen.
What's over there?
Well, there's a rumour going around that Patterson's up the duff. Is that right?
Ask Patterson.
Oh, I wouldn't believe half the stuff she says. I figured you'd know.
You figured right, but what's in my files is between my patients and me.
Yeah, it's a neat setup, isn't it? You could even start up a drug trade if you wanted.
Get out.
Jeez, it was just a joke. Anyone would reckon I hit a sore spot.
Out before I put you on report.
Okay, don't get him knotted.
Moran. Put him on. Alan? G'day, you old son of a gun. How is everybody? Great, great. No. Feels like home already. Well, I'll have my work cut out for a day or two, but I'll soon have the place into shape. Well, you better believe it. Thought I'd run into the local glee club when I arrived. Yeah, right. But the department made it pretty obvious what they want, and I'll get it. Come. Sorry, Alan. Duty calls. Yeah, I'll see you around about 8 o'clock. We'll drink then. Bye. Yes, Mrs. Moran.
Have Connors outside.
Good. Bring her in.
Connors.
You rang?
I've rescinded your transfer order, Connors.
Yahoo!
Troublemakers are my speciality. You keep it up, you'll wish you'd never been born. Get her out.
Connors.
Now, just a bloody minute.
You spoke?
Into buying all this green stuff.
It's a lot healthier than your usual diet of chocolate bars and chips, Denise.
So it is cheaper.
Hey, yeah, I still can't get over how much stuff we got.
Well, remember, I'll be over later with 101 ways of making it taste better, too.
You're on. Hey, she's not bad for being an ex-screw, is she?
There you are. What did I say?
You were right. I really enjoyed myself.
Oh, she's a good kid, really. Just needed time to get away from that mother of hers. I knew them both in Barnhurst,
yes,
you know.
Yes, you told me. And she's obviously determined not to go back there, too.
Of course. She's got me to look after her now, hasn't she, eh?
She's a very lucky girl. They all are, Etty. You're doing a wonderful job.
We're going to make a good team up for you, eh?
I'll certainly do my best.
Good. So now you can come and meet Roach. She's not nearly as bad as she thinks she is. It's just convincing her that's hard. Come on.
Yeah, what?
I bought you a prezzy.
Yeah. What am I supposed to do with it?
Oh, not Mrs. R.
Nice to meet you, Roach.
Wouldn't be too quick on forming an opinion if I were you.
Here now. What do you think?
It's great. Where'd you get it?
Up shop in Richmond. I saw it and I said, that is Roach.
Thanks, Ed. Oh, you silly old bugger.
Now say hello to Mrs. R. She's a mate of mine from Wentworth.
Yeah?
Bet you weren't on the same side of the bars.
No, actually, I wasn't.
Told her she was as smart as a tack. Now, how did the job interview go?
Where do you think? Hell, I was just washing dishes in this cruddy restaurant. And that bitch not only didn't give me the job, she slagged me about me gear.
Look, I told you to tone it down a bit. I mean, I think it's lovely all that colour, but you know what they're like.
Yeah, come on, Ed. Look, I've heard it all before.
Now, listen to me. I'm serious. Some of these buggers can't see past the wrapping. But if you want a few pointers about getting a job, ask Mrs. R here. She knows the lot.
Be glad
to. Nah, look, thanks anyway. Things get too tough, Bongo will help me out. You know, I can't act bloody social workers.
But Mrs. R's not a social...
It's all right, Etty. Roach, is Bongo any relation to Rita Connors out at Wentworth?
Yeah, brother. Hey, you know Reed?
Yes, quite well.
Well, what do you know? Hey, he'll be coming later. Be stoked to meet you. Any friend of Reed's and all that.
And so, at 1 o'clock, I donned the overalls. I just cannot believe how lucky I've been. Well, Mrs. Morris showed me around the place this morning, and I tell you, Joyce, there's enough material there to fill volumes. It's going to be great working at Wentworth. And it's all thanks to you and Mervyn.
Oh, I'm really glad things are working out for you, Steve.
Oh, you're worried, aren't you?
Oh, just being silly, I suppose.
No. If anything does happen, if I get sprung, there's no way you'll get hurt, or Mervyn.
I know. I'm just glad you're getting the opportunity you needed.
Even if I hadn't, it's been great meeting you and Mervyn.
Well, can I give you a lift anywhere?
Oh, no, I'm just going to the post box. I do need to get some sort of exercise, you know, Doctor.
OK, but take it easy. You're not 100% yet, you know.
Oh, so Mervyn keeps reminding me.
Well, don't forget it. And anything I can do, just give us a call.
You could give me a lift out to Wentworth this afternoon.
Joyce.
Well, I just want to see the women. They were so kind to me when I was in hospital.
Oh, she's getting homesick.
Well, I guess I am a little.
I don't see how sending her to Coventry is any sort of punishment.
It'll do for starters.
We could brand her, you know, an alpha lag or
you
something.
You can't do that. You'll bring on a miscarriage.
Good thinking, Egbert, and then she won't be preggers anymore.
You know, anything that could harm a baby, Kelly, and I won't stop till everybody knows about it.
Don't push your luck, Egbert.
Well, she's got a point, Lou.
G'day, Jules. How's it going?
What are you doing here?
Playing silly buggers. Now, you want to hear some news? I mean, everybody else knows. I thought it was about time the top dog heard.
Heard what?
Funny how you're always the last person to find out about anything around here.
Oh, you're all windy.
I mean, you know about the new governor, don't you, Lurch?
Why, governor?
Real macho bastard. Tough as nails and cold as a witch's tit.
You're kidding? Oh, yeah, and when did all this happen?
A couple of hours ago. I reckon you didn't do us any favours getting rid of Reno. This guy's trouble.
You've seen him?
Yeah. Did I ever? Thanks for nothing.
I'll believe it when I see it.
Oh, you want to know something else? I ain't going nowhere. You gov wants me to stick around. Cozy, eh?
Oh, hello, love. How's it going?
Oh, hello again.
My name's Jessie, by the way. And you're Nancy, Mrs. M tells me.
Hello, Jessie. I'm very glad you came. I wasn't sure whether that bell meant lunch or what.
Don't worry. You got a quarter of an hour before indigestion. That was the end of the work bell.
Oh, God. They have bells for everything here, don't they?
This place getting you down already.
Well, it's a bit daunting. I mean, you're the only person who's spoken a civil word to me, apart from the officers.
Ah, you'll be all right when you meet the others. Most of them are okay. Hey, who's this then?
That's my son, Peter.
Oh, he looks a nice young fella. Proud of him too, aren't you?
Yes, very. You know, I've caused him an awful lot of worry.
Oh, go on. He can take it. Got a good solid head on his shoulders by the look of him.
Yes. Have you got any children, Jessie?
Well, no. Not yet, anyway.
If I were you, I'd keep it that way, love. You know, sometimes they can be fair little monsters.
Yeah, I've noticed.
But they make up for it in more ways than one.
G'day, Jess.
Oh, hi.
You two Sheila's heard about the new governor yet?
Male or female?
A bloke. And he's a dead-set mongrel.
What's the matter, love? You're not scared of Reed, are you?
Well, she's not quite what I'm used to, I guess.
Oh, don't worry. She's a good sort if you treat her right. Not like a couple we got round here.
Well, young Peter, isn't it?
Yes, that's right.
What's the problem? Something about your mum?
Yeah,
I'm afraid you've got the wrong place, mate. It's all through Wentworth now. In fact, if you give them the ring, you'll probably find she can have visitors now.
No, that's not why I'm here. She didn't do it. I did it. I killed Dad.
Look, Pete, it's a good story, mate. But I can't see it getting your mum out of prison.
Why not? And she's in there for something she didn't do.
That's not what she told us.
She only did that to protect me. You gotta believe me.
It's been tough on you, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has.
I can understand that, but you're going to have to face up to it. Taking the blame for her isn't going to change anything.
But I'm telling the truth. I killed him, I'm telling you. I don't believe this.
Look. You say she didn't do it, but the fact is she confessed to it. It's up to the jury now. Coming round here and making confessions won't change anything.
All right. Isn't there anything I can do?
Yeah. I'd say she'd really need all the support she can get right now. Now, if you really want to help, you go out there and let her know she's not on her own, OK? Woods.
Yeah.
Hey, don't go to sleep. Old Mother Morris told me to come and take you to the dining room.
Oh, thank you.
And look, I'm sorry I jumped down your throat before, but, well, I didn't even know you were supposed to be in here.
Oh, that's all right. Mrs. Morris explained.
So how are you finding the place so far?
Oh, well, it's a bit hard to say yet.
Well, just take it one day at a time. You'll be right. Start thinking of the long term, you go crazy. Okay, let's go, eh?
Right. Oh, do you think we could ask an officer about getting that window fixed? It's freezing in here.
You better ask, love. If I do, they'll tell me to suffer.
Why?
Because I got a reputation for breaking windows lately. And wouldn't they bust out in boils if they knew why?
Well, whatever the reason, seems a bit stupid to go around breaking windows.
If I want to break a window in my dorm, I'll do it. It's my business, oh, okay?
I'm sorry.
And if you don't want sand shoved down your petrol tank, you better keep your trap shut about what
Rita,
I'm doing.
Rita, I didn't.
I don't want to hear it. Okay? And you can find your own bloody way. Stuff you!
I knew Roach should like you. Gee, I can see you're going to be a hit around here.
Etty, I think she was more thrilled that her boyfriend and I had something in common. She really thinks this Bongo's something special, doesn't she?
Yeah, I'll say she does. The trouble is, he's not good for her, young scallywag.
Yeah, well, I'm certainly not looking forward to meeting the male version of Rita, that's for sure.
I don't blame you, dear.
Bad as that?
Oh, look, don't you worry, I can handle him. You know, what you need is a tonic. You're a bit run down.
Well, Etty, it's all right,
I'll
honestly.
Get it, boys. Up here somewhere. Nice young guy from the chemist made it up for me. Used to do the trick when I was a young girl. Lots of nice iron and stuff.
Thanks, Etty.
There, three times a day. Oh, it tastes bloody awful.
They usually do. Now, where were we?
Eh?
The girl who's just got out?
Oh, Natalie, yes, sweet little thing, isn't she? You'd never dream she's in for armed robbery. But you should just see a little boy. Oh, he's gorgeous.
My God.
Oh, don't worry. It's just Bongo letting Roach know he's arrived.
Pretty half the suburb, though, you mean? Certainly not what I was expecting.
How's it going, Grandma?
Silly old tart.
Just looks like a normal bikey to me.
Oh, the trouble is, you see, he's younger than the rest of them, so he tries to make up for it by being twice as tough. Now, look, you get stuck into that tonic. You're going to need your wits about you to tangle up with him.
Right.
Kill for a fag.
Oh, and g'day to you too. They're on the bloody floor.
Don't get off your bike.
Being a pig of a life.
Yeah? You just took a turn for the better. The top you're grizzling. Hey, you, got any grub?
No, sorry. The cockroach has carried it off. You rotten bugger. You've been bonging on, haven't you?
It's all right. Didn't forget me little mate. Here's lunch. Watch the cockies.
Silly bugger. Hey, I had someone round here today who knows Reet.
Yeah?
Yeah, used to work out at Wentworth. Real do-good by the look of her.
Who?
Name's Anne Reynolds.
What's she doing here?
I don't know. Probably helping Eddie out, I suppose. How come you know her?
Well, that's the bitch that gave Reet a hard time in the nick. She didn't just work at Wentworth, you know. She ran the stinking place.
You're kidding me.
No, remember? Her daughter's wedding. Slasher and the boys supplied a little background atmosphere. Hey, I've got an idea.
Publish it.
Well, don't plan anything for the Sava. We're going to play a little joke on the old gov up there.
No, Bongo, look, leave it alone, eh?
No way. You should hear some of the things Reet tells Slasher about that place.
I don't know. Look, Eddie might get upset.
Oh, screw Eddie. Now, come on. In it or not?
Yeah, okay.
Hey, get us a tinny, will you? Come on.
Stop crawling. You know what?
Hey!
Coventry? Oh, bloody hell.
Better than a dead Lexi.
Yeah, but what else is she gonna dream up?
Jessie's right, Lex. Just be thankful it's working.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I don't know. Look, there has got to be some way we can catch the lagger and keep him off my back.
Oh, doubt it, love. I mean, I'm sure it's that Wilder woman, but she's too bloody smart to get caught.
She can't be that smart. She ended up in here.
Yeah, all right. Well, we'll catch her sometime, no worries. But first, we've got to make sure that you're around to celebrate when we do.
Right. Hey, maybe I could swallow a watermelon pip, you know?
Well, you're on the right track.
Hey?
You still got the hots for that nice young handyman bloke?
Yeah, bit of all right.
Well, that makes it easy then.
What does?
Make him the daddy.
But I don't even know him. Anyway, why should he go along with the story?
Oh, don't be so thick. Make this pregnancy the real thing.
What?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too.